Everyone, welcome to the Meyer Auditorium of the Freer Sackler. Any of you are new tonight, the National Museums of Asian Art of the Smithsonian, and we're very happy to have tonight the opportunity to present this unusual program. We don't get a chance to do dance very often, and certainly not Indonesian dance on our stage, but we have this chance to do the program for a variety of reasons. This program is being presented in collaboration with the Embassy of Indonesia. We're so happy to do that. Again, they were our major partners for the Performing Indonesia Festivals in 2013, 14, and 16. They co-sponsored our online scholarly resource called Performing Indonesia. And they've provided tonight's instruments, rehearsal space last night, and very importantly, food for the musicians. So they're fortified for the performance. I also say that I used to play in the gamelan at the embassy, so it's always kind of a reunion for me. We're also grateful to the University of Richmond for faculty member Andy McGraw, ethnomusicologist, specializes in Indonesia, is performing with us. And from Wesleyan University, not only both of our dancers, but Sumarsam, co-director of the music ensemble, my gamelan teacher from the 1970s and 80s. Before we go on, please do silence your cell phones for the duration of the concert so they don't interrupt the experience for everyone. Please don't use a flash with your camera photography. Make sure that's disabled. When you leave the auditorium, be sure to use the doors you came in through. The other doors have an alarm attached to them. We don't want it going off. And the program will proceed without an intermission, but there is a musical interlude, and the musicians have assured me that it would not be impolite if you need to leave the auditorium for any reason and to come back in time for the second dance item. Well, to give us more of a substantive introduction to what you're about to see and to hear, Emma Stein is the Freer Sackler Curatorial Fellow for Southeast Asia. Her exhibition, Power in Southeast Asian Art, is currently on display in the Sackler Gallery. And she's just recently back from a long trip to Java, where she was doing research on art in the landscape context. So I hope you give a nice warm welcome to Emma Stein.
Thank you, Michael, and thank you all so much for coming tonight. One more piece of logistical information before we start. Tonight's performance is being filmed and live streamed on the Freer Sackler's Facebook page. So before you put away your cell phones, if you want to message any friends in Indonesia or anywhere in the world, please do. And if they can't watch right now, the video will be available on our YouTube channel, so it will remain there. In perpetuity. Tonight's program is unusual in that it presents both classical and contemporary Javanese dance. Typically, these two genres are found in separate contexts. Classical dance is performed in the palaces or other traditional settings. Contemporary dance is usually seen at the arts universities or in theaters. Tonight brings these two styles together. We'll see some of the oldest dance and then some of the newest. Throughout Indonesia, dance is an ancient tradition, but there is no singular Indonesian dance. Indonesia is a vast archipelago. It spans more than 3,000 miles from east to west and includes literally thousands of islands. Indonesia was not even conceived of as a unitary nation until the mid-20th century, and it remains among the most diverse countries in the world. Historically, the different islands each developed unique local styles of dance. These often differ dramatically, even within the space of just a single island. So what we'll see tonight is therefore not just Indonesian dance, but dance from Central Java. Javanese dance is the most refined technique. It takes an astounding amount of strength and control to execute the slow and steady movements that you'll see the dancers perform. For Javanese dance, either classical or contemporary, the dancers have to travel inside themselves to embody the character or the emotion that they portray. I'd invite you then to look for their subtle or unexpected movements, their breath, and their connection to the ground. In Indonesia, power and also spiritual possession begin from the earth and travel up the body. The beat of the drum directs the flow of energy, and the dancers both respond to and control the drum's rhythms. It's now my great pleasure to introduce our esteemed dancers. Sri Maeny is a legend of classical Javanese dance. She has taught at Wesleyan University for 40 years, and she has performed at museums, festivals, and consulates far too numerous to recite here. Pamardi comes to us from the faculty of the Institute of the Arts in Solo, Central Java, where he is a beloved teacher of contemporary choreography. He's steeped in both classical and contemporary Javanese dance, and he too has taught, performed, and choreographed dances throughout the world. The first piece, which is classical, is drawn from the tales of Panji, the legendary folk prince known for his travels. The image on your left is a 15th century temple high on the slopes of a volcanic mountain in East Java. A relief carving, shown on your right, depicts Panji sitting with his beloved in his lap, playing an Indian stringed instrument called a veena. It is a unique representation of this instrument in Indonesia, and it really conjures the sound of the music for us, and also Java's early connections with places across the sea. Unfortunately, around 2010, Panji's head was destroyed or removed. This is a photographic reconstruction that we were able to do by merging an archival image and a current photograph. Natural and intentional destruction is an ongoing challenge at sites throughout Indonesia. We're lucky tonight to be able to enjoy a living art form that is both preserved and continues to grow. So with that, please join me in welcoming our dancers, Ibu Maeny and Pak Pamardi.
Kandrung kandrung kapiranguh Yes.
Nyasak langit-langit sapi itu. Tunyamu iki tunyaku. Kikis-kikis lang kampeng-kampeng tang uripa. kukuteng lan ringkusem. Angepure puan kencono cipar cipur. Tutu koeng darpeni moyane. Butuh iki hatimu lan patiku tebusane. Dadak ono lan tak dadaki. Hatimu tutumpuan bondo lan bandu. Tinengno. Dilingo neroko ubra tahono, neroko ubra tahono, neroko ubra tahono, ridu mawon, mangawur-awur, ngarane nga ngarane curit kong makuru kongso tetep katio putulo warpang ripeng. Berkata ingkang rojo layu